Hey guys, Andrew here from Firerocker Studios, and today I'm in the Minecraft 1.9 update because Mojang just released the 1.9 update, not the pre-release, not a snapshot, but the full update, and I'm going to be showing you guys how you can actually make all of the new little things that they have added, that being shields, how to get elytra wings, and all of the brand new arrows. I'm also going to be telling you guys a couple tips and tricks and other little secrets that you may not have known. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. Also, if you guys enjoy this video, make sure to slap that like button, let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below, and if there is anything else that you guys would like me to show off in this update. I'm only going to be showing you guys the basic stuff. So, here is how to make a shield. It is actually very simple. As you can see, I've got it on right now. I'm also dual wielding. By the way, a couple of quick tips. When you get into the 1.9 update, if you've never been in the snapshots or pre-release, hit F, and that is how you can actually switch from things in your offhand and your main hand. And if you don't want to have anything in your offhand, you just go into your regular inventory. So you first have to select something. So right now, I have nothing, so I've just got my normal main hand. By the way, you could also switch which is your main hand, which is either left or right in the settings. I'll show you that in a second. But for a shield, for example, if I want it to be in my offhand, all I have to do is hit F, and now it is in my offhand, and put it back in my main thing. So that is how you can dual wield. And of course, if I want to switch from a sword, so for example, I'm in first person, if I want to have, by the way, this is how you block. You right click, block with a shield, hit with your sword. If you want to switch them, you can do that, but your sword doesn't work if it's in the offhand. And of course, you could do that with other cool stuff. So if I want to have my bow in my offhand, I could do that, even though there's not much of a point. That's how that looks, blah, 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 all that other good stuff. And you could also block with your shield in other ways like that. So if you're getting attacked, you can go like that. But let's get right into this right now. So how to make a shield is actually very simple. You are going to need to get some wood. Any type of wood works. Just put it into this pattern in your crafting table and put one block or one ingot of iron in the very top just like that. And that is how you get yourself a shield, which is actually very easy. Let me actually put this as the only thing in my main hand. So this is how the shield looks. And if you right click, it does that. You can hit with it as well, I guess, and it's pretty cool. And if I go ahead and put it in my offhand, it blocks like that. If I put it in my main hand, it blocks like that. It's the exact same thing. Also, whatever angle it is facing, it protects you from that side, so it's actually pretty cool, especially when you're shooting. So I could be shooting like this, and it protects that little part of me that is being blocked by the shield, as you can tell, this little part on the left side. So yeah, also some very important stuff with regards to your weapons. There is a cooldown time. If you guys look over here on the right, as soon as I hit, you can see you don't want to be spamming like this. For example, I'll go ahead and put a pig right here, and if I go ahead and hit the pig really fast, you can see he's not dying because I'm not doing fast enough. But I have to, or I'm doing it too fast. I gotta wait for my sword to reload. So hit. Oh, well, let's do another one because that was a pretty good example. But so one hit, wait for it to reload, and another hit. To enable this, it should automatically be enabled. But if it's not, at least I think it should be, but I don't think they have it set. Go to your video settings and hit attack indicator, either hotbar or crosshair. Crosshair is the first option, which it'll show in the very middle, as you can see right around this area. So you want to like wait about a second. It makes this combat a little bit more interesting. Or of course, how I like to have it, if I go back into video settings, have it in hotbar. So there you go. Now back to how to craft the shield. So that is how you make the shield, super simple. Now you could also fix a shield by having two broken shields inside a crafting table. It'll make a brand new fixed shield. And it's actually really simple to make these. Now you could also have them customized with cool designs. So here is how you can have a purple one. Now to have a purple one, all you have to do is have it in the crafting table with a banner. So you got a regular shield and you got a banner of any single type. So you could have a banner with designs or just a plain white banner or a plain purple banner like I did. I'll go ahead and actually show you how that works. So I'll go ahead and put these two right over here. So I put my shield inside of my crafting table. I put my banner in here and bam, I get myself a magenta shield. So there you go. That is how you can have a custom one, and it looks pretty cool. You could also dual wield your shields. Doesn't protect you all that much. I mean, I guess technically it protects you the most, but it doesn't give you much of a, well, I guess you could hit with your hand, but yeah, if you want to do this, you can, I guess. And let's go ahead and actually replace that with that, and let's go on to the next thing over here. So that is how you can make a custom one. By the way, if you want to make a banner, all you have to do is get a stick and 6 wool, which you can get from sheep, and the wool has to be the same exact color. You can have it all purple or white, blah blah blah. And that's how you make a banner. And of course, I've made a video on how to make custom banners. You can put really cool designs on your banners, and that cool design, if you put in a crafting recipe of, if you have a custom cool design on your banner and you put that banner in your crafting table with your shield, it'll go onto your shield as well. And it'll be a little bit cut off because the size of the shield is a little bit smaller than the banner's dimensions, but it'll still be pretty cool. So if you want to have like shields that are all the same as your faction or whatever, that's how you can do that. Elytra wings, I'll go on to that in just a second because you can craft them, but I'll show you the steps on how to get them. But moving on to the brand new arrow. So for one, how to make a bow, same as it used to be, you got three string and then you got three sticks and you do it in this pattern and bam, you got yourself a bow. Now let's go on to the arrows because there are a ton. So kicking it off, how to make a regular arrow for the basics, you're going to want to have flint on the top, you're going to want to have a stick, and you're going to want to have a feather in the bottom. I don't know if the exact pattern has to match like this, but that is how it was on the wiki. And when you do that, you got yourself four arrows. Now to make the coolest one of all, which is the spectral arrow, you're going to need to have an arrow in the middle and you're going to need four glowstone dusts all around, and that will give you two spectral arrows, and I'll show you how they look in just a second. Now to make the really cool tipped arrows, all you have to do is have a lingering potion in the middle of any kind, and you're going to need to fill the rest of your spots with arrows. So it is about eight arrows and then one lingering potion, and that will give you eight arrows of whatever it is that you have. So here for example, this was a potion of leaping, so you've got arrows of leaping. And this is jump boost 22. So some of them are positive, some of them are negative. So I'll go ahead and show you all of the arrow types right now. So if I do arrow and then space, you can see these. Now, of course, this is more than 14 because there are 14 arrows based on the potions. And of course, there's different versions of the effect. So for example, there is strength, for example. So you have strength and then you have strength 2. So that's why there's more than 14 over here. Now, of course, there's ones that are positive, there's ones that are negative. When you get hit by these, it'll pop up on the top right a little animation that you've been hit with the effects, and it'll blink faster and faster until it's gone. If it's positive, I believe it's on the top, and negative is in the bottom, but I could be wrong. I'll show you that in just a second. But listing all of the potions that you could use, or all of the arrow types. There is arrow of regeneration, arrow of swiftness, arrow of fire resistance, healing, night vision, strength, leaping, invisibility, poison, weakness, slowness, harming, water breathing, and luck. So those are all of the ones that you can have. I have them actually listed down. The duration of the effects is 1/8 that of the corresponding potion. So for example, if your potion that you put on is for 2 minutes, it'll be 1/8 of that. And so other stuff about this, let's go on to the really cool one, which is the spectral arrow. So I'll go ahead and actually spawn myself a piggy right over here, and let's go ahead and another really cool thing that you could do, if you have the arrows in your offhand, so if I happen to have that in my offhand right over there, I will use that arrow. So I just went ahead and hit the pig with the spectral arrows. You can see it does an outline around the pig. It also works on all the mobs, including the ender dragon. I don't know about every single mob, but I'm pretty sure I know that it works on the ender dragon. Now this is very useful, for example, time set, let's do 18,000. So it is nighttime right now. Let me go ahead and before anything make this peaceful so we don't have to deal with mobs. If I go ahead and hit the pig, well, he is now dead because he couldn't handle that much pain. But if I go ahead and hit the piggy right now, you could see the outline works really well at night, and the most important thing, it actually goes through blocks, so you can still see the pig even though there's several blocks in between us. So this helps a lot if you are in a battle with a bunch of other people and somebody gets hit by this, and you'll be able to see them even if they go underground. It'll mark their base, and it's really useful in general. And of course, this is also a really cool feature because if you are into modifying the game a bit and making your own custom plugins or whatever, or just using command blocks for awesomeness, this actually works really well with teams, because let's say there is a team setting in, I don't know, a red versus blue battle, and they're using this effect. If you are in the red team and the blue team hits you, you will actually glow the color red instead of just the default color, which is white. So that's a pretty cool feature, and yeah, you can kind of see how that works. Now let me go ahead and switch this and put that on my side right over there. So I have my arrow of, let me see, what is this called? It is the arrow of leaping. So I'm going to go ahead and hit myself with it, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to get shot by it. I'm hoping. I don't know if it'll hit me with it. Is it affecting me? I'm not really sure. But point is, the animation will show up on the top right when you are hit with an arrow. So, and of course it'll go away and it'll stack up. So if you got hit by like three different types of arrows, it'll show all the effects and it'll blink faster and faster until it's gone. Now on to the coolest thing, which is Elytra Wings. As you can see, I have actually a cape on. So if I go ahead and take off my wings, you can see here is my Minecon cape. Now if I go ahead and put that back on, or put my Elytra Wings back on, you can see that it actually matches with my cape. So if you have a cape, your Elytra Wings will match with them. So it's actually a pretty cool little neat thingy and stuff. But Elytra Wings, very useful. Now I'm going to tell you guys how to get them, and then I'm going to show you a couple of tricks with the Elytra Wings themselves. For one, you find them in the end cities in a ship. Now, I've already made a video talking about it, so I'm going to go real fast through this. Now, that is how they look, by the way. Now, to get them, the process, let's say you just started a brand new world. First things first, you're going to need to get yourself 3 diamonds. So, the process of that, of course, you're going to have to get yourself a stone pick so you can get iron. Then, you're going to get diamond with that. Or, first, you're going to get iron because you need to make an iron pick. So, that's the only way you can break diamonds. Then, you're going to have to get 3 diamonds. So, you're going to have to go really deep into the core of the game's planet. And then, you're going to need the 3 picks to make a diamond pick because once you have a diamond pick, you need to get 10 obsidian to make the portal. Now, to make a portal, it's a pretty simple design. I'll go ahead and put it out right over here so people can see. Just do that pattern, and of course you don't have to actually put them all down, so let's pretend that I'm in survival. Put another block there to skip this process so you don't have to waste your obsidian, but you are going to need the minimum of at least 3 blocks high and then 2 blocks wide. So basically just like this, and you do that, ignite it with flint and steel, and then you can go into the nether. So yeah, super simple. Now you're gonna have to be very well armed when you are in the nether, because you're gonna have to actually find, oh, I don't know, did I put my shield? Oh, there we go. Okay, you are gonna need to find yourself a stronghold or an end fortress, but or not end fortress, another fortress. And once you do that, you're gonna have to find yourself a couple of blazes, kill a couple of them, because you're gonna need 6 blaze rods. When you put that in your crafting table, you will, each blaze rod equals 2 blaze powders. You're gonna need 12 in total, so you're gonna need, say, 6 blaze rods, which will give you 12 blaze powders. Then you're gonna need to come back to the regular world, and you are gonna need ender pearls. By the way, a little tip, bring an ender chest with you when you go into the nether, so if you do finally get all your stuff, you can just put it in there and then kill yourself so you don't have to find your way back in case you can't find your way back. Now, you're gonna need 12 ender pearls because you put 1 ender pearl with a blaze powder and it'll give you an eye of ender. Now, you're gonna need 12 eyes of ender. One in general, because all you really have to do is, let me show you. So if I do slash game mode 0, and I go ahead and I believe all I have to do is right click on the ground, or maybe I spit it like that. I don't remember. Why's this not working? Survival mode. I'm confused. But point is, you use the Eyes of Ender to be able to find yourself a stronghold. Maybe it doesn't work because I'm in this type of world. But yeah, you normally would just use the Eyes of Ender to get you into a stronghold. Now, there are a bunch more strongholds in the brand new 1.9 update. There used to be only 3 in the world. Now there's like 100 something. So it's really easy to find them. But yeah, now once you have the 12 Eyes of Ender, you're going to find yourself a stronghold in the overworld, which is the regular world. Once you found a stronghold, go into it, explore it, find the portal, which basically has like a 3x3 pattern of the end portals, which you need to right click with each of your Eyes of Enders, and it places it on top. Once you've completed the whole entire pattern, it'll open up the portal, you'll jump in it, and bam, you are in the end. Now, the end is a brand new arena, which you're gonna have to fight the dragon, and you're gonna also have to destroy all of the end crystals. And the end crystals, some of them, the tallest ones, are actually covered in a cage with iron bars. So like I said, it's very complicated. You're gonna have to snipe some of them off. Make sure you have shields and a bunch of armor and stuff when you go in there. Once you take out the ender crystals, then you can kill the dragon. The reason why I have to take out the end crystals is because they actually generate the dragon's health over and over. The dragon also is a lot stronger now. It's got dragon's breath, which is a brand new effect. So just be very careful when fighting the ender dragon. Also, you can respawn the end dragon. Once you've killed it, there's a brand new portal that opens up. There's the same old portal and a new one in the sky, which if you shoot an ender pearl through it, so you're gonna actually need 13 ender pearls, and one of them you're gonna have to leave as an actual ender pearl. If you shoot the ender pearl with it, it'll actually take you to the brand new end dimension, and the regular one is also there. You just have to go back into it from the overworld, and then yeah, go through the portal, blah blah blah, same process. You can actually respawn the ender dragon if you want to fight it over and over by simply making the end crystals all over again, which just, I'll make a separate video about how to craft that. But yeah, also there's rare drops once you fight the dragon over and over. This is, I believe, one of them. As you can see, it's really cool that mouth actually moves, and it's one of the new features in the 1.9 update. But enough about that, let's continue on with what I was talking about. So, after you have defeated the dragon, and you've shot an ender pearl into the portal, you will be in the brand new end cities, which you're gonna have to explore a lot. There's a lot of endermen, so be very careful. You're gonna be fighting the shulker mob when you finally find an end city that has an end ship floating right next to it. Now, the shulker mob is pretty annoying to defeat, so let me go ahead and make this easy mode. So I'll go ahead and spawn this bad boy up, and I think maybe I have to go into, let's do this, game mode 0. So if I go ahead and hit this bad boy, oh, there we go. So he actually is impossible to kill. Oh, there we go. I'll let him give me the effect. So the effect, oh, I don't know why it's not working. But the effect basically makes you launch up. I guess it's maybe because I'm in a super flat world. Oh, no, there we go, it's working. So, you're gonna wanna hit these things, and let me go into game mode 1. They're very easy to hit, just like that. Also, you can't kill the Shulker mob if he's close like this. You gotta wait for him to open up. So once he's open, then you can give him a couple of critical hits. Again, make sure you're not spamming it, or else you won't really give it any damage. I'll go ahead and make this peaceful again. But yeah, there's about 2 or 3 Shulker mobs on the end ship. That is where you'll find the Electrowings. And that's basically it. Once you've gone to the Shulker mob part, you will get to the Electrowing part. And the Electrowings are inside the ship in the very back, and they are actually on a frame just like this. So you basically just right-click them, you get them, and then you can fly your way back into the overworld. Now, a couple things about Electrowings. If you get 2 Electrowings that are broken and you put them in a crafting table, they will give you a fixed one, but that's kind of a waste because they're super rare. The better thing to do is actually to get leather and put them in a crafting table. Now, if you get up to 4 leather in a crafting table with Electrowings, it'll fully heal it. Now, Electrowings have a durability of 431. Every second is about, I think of 431 as the amount of seconds that you can fly. Let me actually go ahead and lower the volume real quick of this. So, every single leather that you get, let's say you have your Electrowings and fully broken, if you put them in the crafting table with 1 piece of leather, it'll heal it 108 durability. And of course, if you get 4 leather, it'll max it out and you will be all set to go. So yeah, 4 pieces of leather will fully heal your Electrowings. So make sure to start farming your cows if you want to always have Electrowings on you. Now, a couple of other cool things that you can do. And it is actually very simple. I don't know why that broke. But if you get yourself an anvil and you get an enchantment book of unbreaking, you can get it unbreaking 1, 2, or 3. I recommend 3. Put that in an anvil, so I'll actually show you how this looks. So let's go ahead and get these 2 in here. So if I go into my anvil, I put my Electrowings and I put my enchantment book. There you go. You get Electra with unbreaking 3. And it actually has the exact same effects as it would if you were to enchant it on tools. So there you go. That's how you get them with this cool effect. And it's pretty sweet. Now, to finish this off, a couple of things that you're going to want to know about the Electrowings. For one, they've changed it a bit since the last time I made a video with Electrowings. Instead of just automatically gliding the second you jump off, you kind of have to double tap your space button. So let me go ahead and go into game mode 0, which is survival mode. Now, I'll go into third person and I'll show you. When you jump off, you're going to want to keep double tapping. That way, it actually enables your wings. Now, a couple of neat little things about the Electrowings. It's not just gliding down. You can actually fly for an unlimited amount of time if you... Well, not unlimited amount of time, until they run out. But you can fly pretty much forever until they run out if you kind of fly in a certain type of pattern. You kind of go in a... You have to land, or not land, but go down in a 45 degree angle. Let me go ahead and actually make my video settings so clouds are on so you can kind of see everything. So I am going to real quick do game mode 0, and now I am going down pretty fast in a pretty big angle, and what I am actually going to do is pull up right now, and as you could see, I am actually right back at the cloud level. Now I am going to aim down like this, stay in my 45 degree angle. I am getting a lot of speed. Now this is very important because it's basically making it so that I can continue to fly forever. Now there's also a couple of other neat tricks that you can do. Let me just try to get my way back onto where I was. But yeah, you can do a bunch of really cool tricks when you are flying with your Electrowings. Again, make sure you're flying in this pattern so you can continue to go up and down and fly pretty much forever. Now, I'm gonna go do a quick little dive so I can get some speed so I could show you some of the pretty cool tricks you can do. Now, when you go up, you can actually spin your mouse, so you can do barrel rolls, cool things like that. You can do a straight dive down. You can kind of glide slowly. Now, you only get damage if you're going really fast and you hit a wall, or if you're diving straight down. But aside of that, if you kind of pull upwards, not directly up because then you'll fall straight flat. If you kind of look like this when you're falling, so let me do slash game mode 1 and fly up. And I'll show you. These can basically work as parachutes if you're gliding down in a smart fashion. So game mode 0. So if I kind of glide down like this, I'm pretty much falling as if I had a parachute. So some of the tricks you can do, you could also shoot your arrows or your bow while you're in the sky. You can have shields on you and all of that really cool stuff. But yeah, and of course when you shift, you can do that. You can actually go through a block that's only 1x1. And when I say 1x1, I literally mean like this. So let me go ahead and, let me go into game mode 1. So going back to creative. So you can actually fly through a block like this. You will get a little bit of damage, but if you fly perfectly through it, you can actually go through a block like that. So that's one of the tricks with Electrowings that's actually pretty cool. It's actually been shown by Jeb. But yeah, a bunch of really cool stuff. You can throw eggs and everything. Pretty much you could shoot anything that you normally could while you are on your Electrowings. So yeah, guys, it's pretty cool. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and it helped you out and you learned a couple of tricks and tips and crafting recipes. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to slap that like button. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And of course, subscribe for new videos every single week. And that's pretty much it for me. Like always, I'm Andrew from FireRocker Studios. You guys are rockers. Let me know your thoughts, suggestions, anything else you guys would like to see me do in the comment section down below. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye!